Hey, how's it going, my fine sirs? My name is Sir Earl Grey, and welcome back to the second part of episode 4 of Life is Strange. And holy shit, the last episode was emotional. But we've just left the hospital, and we're about to go and interrogate and hopefully find a shit ton of dirt on the arsehole Nathan Prescott. And I can't wait to play some more, so let's head straight back in. Oh, and this is the principal and Mr. Jefferson. Why are we seeing them? This is a very nice campus, by the way. You okay there, dude? Just chilling? Everybody's chilling. Everybody's enjoying the summer sun. There's a totem here? That's very strange decor. Hey, what's up?
Hey, Max. How you doing?
Oh, hi, Mr. Jefferson. I'm okay. And this is my
friend
Chloe.
Yeah.
Chloe? Why isn't somebody as cool
well,
as
I did.
You going to Blackwell?
I was
but,
school.
I wasn't
story in actual files here.
I can imagine. Max, are you sure that you're all right?
It's weird just being on campus like everything's normal.
I know. Lame as it sounds, life has to go on.
I think there's too much going on in my life.
On that note, Blackwell duty calls. Remember, I'm going to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes contest tonight at the party. So I hope.
Did I submit my photo?
Even though I'm sorry you didn't enter a photo. I understand your reasons. You can't force an artist to work.
Oh.
I feel like a total loser, but.
Okay, so I've given a free pass on that.
No pun intended.
I'm proud of you for caring so much about a troubled friend. And I take hope in the fact that you have plenty of time to find your way. Just get in the habit of putting your work out there.
Thanks, Mr. Jefferson. I'll definitely be there tonight.
Me too. I'll be Max's date. You better dance with us at least once.
Nobody should have to see me dance. Plus, you don't want to watch the old hipster trying to keep up with the kids. I have some pride. Be seeing you.
Yes, you will.
Oh, Max.
Hot for
Stop being so flirtatious.
You're out of control.
Not yet. Just wait until the rager tonight.
Shut up.
Don't be jealous because Mark Jefferson thinks I'm cool.
I am so ignoring you.
Fine. Since I'm here, I'll see if I can get some dirt from Justin. I haven't talked
Who's
to him in
Justin?
While.
Now that's
All right, you go whatever you need to do, Chloe. I'll try and use my own investigative skills.
People here push me into lockers.
Oh, bro. God damn it. Just because you're a bit chubby and you come from somewhere where they speak Spanish, shouldn't let yourself down. Go to the party, don't go to the party. See, if your friends are there. If you have no friends there, what's the fucking point? You'll just stand out, you'll have a bad time and people will pick on you. Make your own party with your own friends and make it even more fun than a shitty one that with your enemies. So don't go to the party.
Screw the Vortex
Exactly.
Club. They don't deserve you, Daniel.
They don't deserve anything. I mean, what do they actually do for Blackwell, huh? You're right, Max.
See?
Screw them.
All right, I need a little bit more about Nathan.
By the way, have you seen Nathan Prescott?
You mean lately?
Like, anytime today?
I saw Jefferson talking with Nathan a little while ago, but I try to stay out of his way. I have enough assholes to deal with here.
Fair enough. And what about Kate?
Have you talked to anybody about what happened with Kate?
I don't talk to anyone, Max. But
oh, baby.
I did actually have a nice talk
Jesus.
With Brooke. She couldn't stop talking about how brave you were
oh,
on
thank
the
you.
Roof.
I don't think doing the right thing is brave.
Hey, you were brave, Max.
I appreciate what she means. The most important thing is that Kate gets better and gets justice.
I hear that, Max. She's the sweetest, most genuine person I've ever met. I don't mind getting picked on by
bro holes. Nice.
Hesitate.
I like this revolutionary
Exactly.
Acosta.
Only if I can start the revolution from my sketchbook, Max.
You
Let's
go for it, Daniel.
Here. Okay, Daniel.
Aw, you're sweet. You're nice. But seriously, though, stop with the fedora t-shirt. It's not doing you any favors. All right, Chloe, I've done my digging. Whoa, I just disappeared.
Coast
that was
clear.
Pretty cool.
It would be so cool if you
Well, I can go through time and space at will, so it makes sense actually.
Ugh, you suck. Now let's get into Blackwell ninja mode.
Ninja mode? We truly were ninjas in the previous episode. It was so cool escaping the school at night. Freaking awesome. Undetected as well. Okay, what's next?
So this lame. They don't have co-ed dorms here.
Yes, because I want Nathan Prescott in the room next door.
Yeah. No one wants that.
Wait here.
You just want that for the sexy time, Chloe. And to go a little bit wild.
Batmax. Now I just have to find Nathan's room.
Okay, should be a piece of cake. You just go into every single one of the rooms and rewind when you get shouted at when someone's changing. Kate, you babe, you got me Nathan's number. Okay, room 111.
So, room 111 is the magic number.
111, 11, 11, 11. Somewhere around here. 110, 109. Oh. But it goes up to 110. Sorry, Kate. What?
Looks like one of the jocks did care about Kate.
Ah, the plot thickens. So it's not here. This is 109, and this is 110, and it's one. Ah, it's this one. The Prescott rules this town. Great.
This can only be Nathan's room.
Really classy. I bet it won't be open. It'd be way too easy. Fire extinguisher time, baby. And then you just need to rewind. Max, you freaking beast. Oh. A freaking home cinema in his room. Really? All right, let's rewind time before we get caught.
Now I need to find Nathan's phone or anything with clues.
Sounds like a plan. All right, okay. So we've got a camera.
That monochrome camera is brand new and costs about $6,000. Bastard.
Damn, and it's monochrome as well. You don't even get color.
I thought Victoria had the photo bling, but...
Yep.
Once again, the Prescott's rule.
Can't beat with their
so
capsule.
Cute and ironic. I can't believe Nathan still has it around.
Oh. This diploma certifies that Nathan Prescott is officially the best son in the world. Oh, signed by his dad. There's some definite daddy issues with him. Drawer open.
That is so Chloe.
Hey arsehole, we need to talk. I'm going to tell everybody what you did, and you're going to pay, motherfucker.
Oh my god. Chloe.
Jesus.
Oh, Chloe.
That does not look good. Did he take advantage of her as well? I sure hope not. If not, he is going to pay even more.
Sean Prescott might be Nathan's real problem.
Yep, what a surprise. Nate, I know this has been a stressful week and your mother and I are here to talk if need be. Just make an appointment anytime. Wow, dad of the year. Your mother wants Dr. Bill to come out after his book tour, but for now let's stick to our prescriptions. I need you calm and quiet while Pan Estates is being developed. I know being a Prescott is a burden. I'll guide you into this room step by step as did my father. It was hard for me when my dad opened my eyes to our destiny, but you'll thank me someday. Don't worry about Blackwell. This shithole town is going to get an enema along with its fresh brand. I want you to be ready to take over when the moment is right. Don't fuck it up, son. Your father.
Too bad Nathan isn't more like his sister. She sounds awesome. And far away. What the hell are all those marks on the floor?
It's the couch has been moved. That's what it is. Move the couch, Chloe. Chloe. Max. What am I saying? There you go.
Let's find out what you're hiding.
Got some nice dirt. Nice. Nicely done, Max.
Oh yes, little phone. You are mine now.
Excellent. And I'm sure there's a few drugs, a couple of dollar bills in there as well.
Now I have Nathan's phone, so I can show it to Chloe. Well, before Nathan comes back.
That
cool.
Sounds...
Now it's opened.
Good. Okay, and we didn't get caught as well. Well, we're still in the boys' dormitory, so...
Please stay away, Nathan.
Nice. Well, Chloe was keeping watch, so... Nothing bad could happen. Let's go.
Damn, Max, you're finally back. I got worried. So, what did you find?
Good
His
things.
His room was clean and creepy.
What's wrong with a clean room? Check sure, mine out. Isn't very clean today because I'm moving out soon, but usually it's relatively spick and span.
Boom,
and I'm not
Nathan.
Creepy.
We got you by the balls,
all the time. Ah, oh, fuck.
What are you doing in my dorm?
isn't your dorm. It's the boys' dorm.
You're such a nosy bitch, Max.
Stop right there, Nathan.
Make me ho.
Just call me a ho.
Max,
who is it? Warren.
I got this.
Nice. My
Get
hero.
Out of my face.
I don't. Fuck yes, Warren. You're a fucking
you
legend.
So fucking dead.
Jesus.
Get off me, bro.
Bro. Stop, Warren. Okay. Jesus,
Wait,
sad enough.
Stop it. Come on.
Can't believe he pulled a gun on us.
Oh, my head. Why are y'all looking at me like that, huh? You and you, you're all dead.
Yeah, just, yeah, you try
yeah.
it, man.
Plus, my dad is on his way. You're all fucked. He owns you.
The fuck is wrong with this asshole? Warren, you're freaking...
Even if Nathan definitely deserved a beating, we should try to be better than
Yeah,
that.
Exactly. And God knows what would happen if we'd, like, seriously injured him. Oh, Warren, you're an absolute beast. You fucking headbutted him.
Damn. That was intense.
Oh, you look so black and blue.
Thank you so much.
For what?
For headbutting Nathan Prescott. That was awesome.
It freaking was.
I almost went crazy there. Like Nathan.
Hey, it's fine. Like you stopped. That's
know.
The important thing.
So where are you going? I better stick with you guys. Just in case you need me to get my Hulk on again.
Aw.
Or should I call
so
the cops
cute.
No police. Not yet. So maybe you better...
Warren, me and Max have to do this on our own.
Oh.
No offense.
But why?
Cool. Whatever I can do to help.
Come on,
what
bring him on board.
Find out anything you
like, he's helped you so much.
I'm on it. Between the snow and eclipse, I'm assuming the apocalypse is around the corner.
And thank you. Seriously.
Come on, give him a hug. At least.
You better. I'm feeling pretty alpha now.
Yes, you are.
What a boss. Ron, you're the real MVP.
Man, that guy is so fucking in love with you.
What did I say?
I know.
He really did give a serious beat down to Nathan.
It was a little scary to watch him do that.
Now let's make a date with Frank.
Will he even answer you?
Frank always answers when he wants money.
Wait, how are we supposed to get the money back?
Like
I don't understand.
Frank wants to see me right now.
Let's not keep him waiting.
Okay, so we got the phone, but what does that help us with Frank? Have I missed something, sirs? I think I have. Oh, but whoa. Freaking beast, man. He was freaking awesome. But we're at a beach. Nice. Except for the dead giant whales, of course. Which probably really, really stink. But hey, at least there's a lot of meat there to go around. Might as well not let it go to waste. Question is,
God.
He will definitely...
I hate seeing those poor whales like that.
Me too. I just think of their families in the ocean out there looking for them.
But yeah, Frank will definitely know that
what?
You...
What? You actually shoot him? Chloe...
He definitely know that his gun is missing.
My rewind. Seriously.
Obviously, I'm not counting on you. That's why I have a gun. And I might even save you someday.
Unlikely. You'll probably shoot yourself again.
I'm going to hit you.
All right, come on, girls, let's go.
I could have guessed this is what would happen to us when we grew up.
We're going up against a drug dealer.
We can just go on a road trip to Portland.
Fuck yeah. You, me, and Rachel.
Absolutely. So let's play this cool, okay? Just talk to Frank so we can get that code for the book from him. That's all.
Got it.
Sounds like a plan. Yeah, exactly. Do not deviate from the plan. All right. Let's do this. We've got a flyer. Hey, exciting. Glad we're getting distracted by the small things.
There might not be any Pan Estates by Saturday.
Oh. Thanks to local industry, the shores of Arcadia Bay are now unfit for fish, birds, and even whales. It's time to stop the Pan Estates development that is leading to the destruction of jobs, lives, and resources. Join the peaceful process of the Pan Estate HQ. Medias and families are welcome. Ooh, this is the stuff that Nathan's dad was all about. Beach ball, very interesting. It's very pretty though. The art style, I think, really shines.
It blows my mind that I was just here with Chloe in an alternate reality.
Say that again. Let's take a photo. But the art style, really, I think, really shines when you're on the beach and with the whales and everything. Look, makes it look very, very pretty. Sweet. Got us a nice photo. And we got us a sign. Alright, I think it's time to face the beast. We can look through his window first.
Can't see inside with this shit blocking
nope.
The view.
Okay, never mind. Table, dog bowl, garbage. Anything interesting in here?
Take the trash out sometime, dude.
Nope. Okay, it's probably been there for weeks, so let's not look in there. All right, let's go. Sup, dude?
Oh, look. The Wonder Twins.
How's it going?
Should have come alone.
She's my partner.
Yeah, we're inseparable. Yeah, haven't you noticed? Guard.
So let's get to business. Where's my fucking money?
I don't have the money. Yet.
Oh, really? Then why did you text me that you did?
Because I wanted to tell you in person.
Oh, I'm truly touched, Chloe. Now, why are you losers really here?
We just want to ask you some questions.
You have some serious lady balls.
I do.
No.
Come on, stop being an asshole.
Jesus, okay.
That was
not getting you high.
That was a flip of a coin.
Frank, we're not here to get high.
No, you don't look like the type. Not like Chloe here. So what do you hardy boys want?
We need information.
What's the names of some of your clients?
Oh, is that all? Oh, well, why didn't you just tell me? How about I just give you the keys to my RV while
Hey, if you're offering, I'll gladly take them. You already did.
You already did.
Ah, you fucking mental. I lost my keys, but I changed the lock. You better goddamn not be snooping around here.
No, I'm not.
Oh, Christ, I hate you, Blackwell. Shit. You expect everything for free. You're not getting
That was not a good answer. But I just wanted to see his reaction.
Yes, Frank. Without those Blackwell shits as customers, you wouldn't have any work at all. Dude, you're a drug dealer.
You snobby whores. Don't come into my home and judge me. That's why I go to church. And you want something from me? How about a blade up the ass, huh?
Hey, that's not very nice. Come on, man.
Don't you ever tell me what to do. Get it, bitch? Get it?
Whoa.
Step the fuck back now!
Oh, great. No!
Fucking killed my dog!
Oh my god!
Well. Fuck. That was awful. You just killed someone. Well done. That's what happens when you have a gun. Frickin' idiot.
I just shot a man and his dog. I killed Frank Bowers.
You saved my life, Chloe. It was self-defense for
not really.
Max? Frank is really dead.
I know, but we can't stop now. We have to find that cop.
No, wait, no. You wait, okay.
Before the cops come.
Oh, so we're gonna rewind after this, says. Like, there's no way we're gonna let this pass. We just let Chloe kill a dog.
Let's get out of here.
Sorry, Frank. I'm sorry.
Max, yes, there you go. There's no way!
Chloe actually killed Frank. She'll never forgive herself. Or.
Like, I wonder who would in their right minds could leave this situation like this. Fuck this, no way. We got the code. Wait, actually, we need the code. Do we have the code? Max. Well, it's too late now, but... Oh, we have to go back far, sirs. There you go. Right to the beginning.
Frank, you knew Rachel almost better than anybody. And you know more than us. Together, we could find her. Do you have anything to lose?
Oh,
when Rachel vanished,
that's a pretty sound argument, actually.
I can't stand not knowing where she is. Not hearing her voice or her laugh.
Oh, bro.
We can change all that. It's up to you.
Tell me.
Help us find her, Frank. Please. We really need your client list.
Come on, you know it's the right thing to do.
Well, if there's a chance in hell, you two dorks can find Rachel.
Nice.
I'll take it. My dog isn't barking at you, so I guess that's a good sign.
All right, sirs. Nice one. And no one got shot.
Thank you.
No one got stabbed.
Yeah, thanks, Frank. Seriously.
It's hard to take you characters seriously, but I want to. Good luck.
Oh, yeah. Flawlessly done, sirs. It's funny because obviously we could have gotten our outcome in so many different ways. But this one, I think, is the best one. No, don't. Chloe, don't pick it up. Just leave it there. I was really hoping you'd forget it, actually. That's just how it is. Whoa, she walks pretty fast. Maybe she has the power to manipulate time and space as well. But I think for now, just one person with the supernatural powers will be enough. Leave the beach. Okay, sirs. Damn, that was really like Groundhog Day. Going back every time you made a mistake to have the perfect argument and the perfect answers to everything. But the evidence wall is increasing very well.
Chloe, are you okay?
Well, she didn't shoot anyone, so she was better. She's better, definitely.
I'm glad things worked out okay with Frank. It's nice to have one less enemy in Arcadia Bay.
Well, you still owe him money, so that won't go away. Just saying. Although, if you manage to find Rachel, he may forgive you. Okay.
I better focus on this board and start tying these clues together.
Sounds like a plan. Gather info on a character by selecting all the correct clues. For each section, there's a specific number of clues to select.
Let's look right. at Frank's drug deals during the week of the party.
Okay. How about we look at the log? Oh, this might involve quite a lot of thinking, sirs.
Yes.
Oh.
The game is on.
Wait, now, did that actually work?
Talk to us, account book.
I think that was a complete fluke. Oh, well. Hey, nice one, sirs. Look at those superior hacking skills. What do you need? The G? Okay, cool. Bitch, you sold me water, arsehole. Calm down, bring it to me. Bring it. Stay away, pigs on the beach.
Yes.
You got to the party night home. On the way, load the bowl.
To score for the Vortex Club party.
Yep.
Nathan was jonesing hard the night of the party. He didn't have enough drugs.
Interesting, interesting.
Drug dealer drama.
Okay.
God, Nathan, you're out of control.
You tweaking soon. Hook up the brother up, please. May the bitch be cool
so
this time.
It was you.
Keep your smart mask.
Now
oh, yeah.
Officially call you a psycho stalk.
Yep. Oh, well, that was no surprise that he sent us this text.
That's brutal.
Please do not contact me at work. I've told you this before. Being high is not an excuse anymore. This is a business, not just a hobby. You want me to treat you like an adult who can get things done on his own? Impress me. I'd like nothing more than to be proud of you. I'm not there yet. What an arsehole. Okay. All three pieces of evidence are together. Investigate.
Take a breath, Max.
Oh shit.
Go through all this.
I have
data
to connect
and
them all.
Can find out where Nathan took Kate after the party.
Oh, this might not be easy.
Chloe, this is definitely the place.
I've got it.
Let me dig up some more clues here.
Oh, thank God for that. I was stuck for quite a while, but I think I managed to find where.
Nope, nothing, Max.
Shit.
There's nothing here. Just some shitty old barn.
Ah, but that could be the place.
Let's keep searching and find out who owns this haunted barn.
Exactly.
I'm on this.
Hold on. I'm searching where Nathan took Kate after the party.
Somebody named Harry Aaron Prescott.
Yeah.
I'm shocked.
What a surprise.
Should we Call the police?
Fuck that. You know the police here are like Nathan's private security,
right? That's right.
That's so messed up.
As you've noticed, this whole town is messed up. We can't trust anybody except each other. So we have to go out to that farmhouse by ourselves.
Oh, that sounds like a risky business.
We could call Warren since he kicked Nathan's
yes.
ass.
Yes, I agree.
It's just the two of us.
No, come on.
And I'm not scared at all. You have the power.
But Warren is our bro.
I feel like we're this close to finding Rachel. We have to find her, Max.
We will. But remember, my power isn't infinite. We still have to be careful.
Yep, exactly.
Do you hear, Chloe?
That's why I think bringing Warren is a good idea. Bringing an extra person just opens up your options more. Right? So, you're more likely then to get the outcome that you want. But I've got a really big feeling that shit's gonna go down in this section. We've played detective, and now it's time to catch the criminal.
Holy shit, this is scary.
Ah, it's fine, it's still daylight.
But we're here. Let's go find the best way in.
The best way in, huh? Can't just open the door? Would that be too easy?
Whoa, check this out. Fresh tire tracks.
Dude, somebody was just here.
Interesting. There's a padlock on there.
Need to get in that bar.
Maybe they're still there. Right, so let's have a little bit of exploration. Can we just blow up this petrol canister? No? Or was that too Michael Bay for the likes of Max? But this was not very safe. Just opened up a hole in the wall. Oh well.
Chloe, I found the front door. Come on.
Sweet. Oh, for a minute I thought it wasn't her.
Oh, yes, Maximus rules.
I do.
God, this is way too Blair Witch. I have goosebumps all over. Come on, Max.
Let's try our best to discover some clues.
Hey, check out this old chest.
A little louder, Chloe.
Jeez, that is ancient.
Jackpot. Old shit.
No, look closer.
Just not old shit.
Harry
documents.
Aaron Prescott and family donate new library to Arcadia Bay. Prescott Industries celebrate grand opening. The Prescotts bring bomb shelter boom to town.
Nice scrapbook. You search for more clues and I'll scope out the area.
Okay. That's a treasure trove of information. Get it? Because it's in a chest. I'm so lame. Warren, thanks for pulling me off Nathan. Talk about going ape. He deserved a good beat down. I didn't want to stoop to his level. Besides, somebody's going to kick his ass sooner or later. You are wise, grasshopper. Yes, you are. Thanks, but I wasn't exactly the hero this town needs. You still paid your hero's dues. Now we just need some costumes. Speaking of, I hope you're coming to the party tonight so we can celebrate. I'll let you know, promise. Cool. Now I have to calm myself down. Warren, you're a boss. Nathan, pussies can't fucking fight. Can't even spell correctly. Oh, sirs, we might have found something. Underneath the hay. Is it going to be like a trap door or something? Yes.
What is this?
Leading into the basement.
Totally brand new. Why?
Okay, let's try and open it. I'm
no,
not expecting
Supermax.
You. Yeah.
You can't open this with your bare
I
hands.
Thought so. Let's try and use a pitchfork, maybe? I saw one back over. Ooh, we can
okay,
use
Chloe,
this.
I found some kind of hatch, but it's locked. I got this.
Nice. Okay.
Let me know the second you need any help.
Excellent. And then we have the button over here. Over someplace here. No?
There's no way this rusty ass.
But why?
Activate these ropes or pulleys.
Come on, Max. Be more positive. Oh, Jesus.
Ugh, so that didn't work at all.
That wasn't what I wanted to do at all. I wanted to attach the rope to it, not just push it off the edge. Okay, so. Maybe attack. There you go. That's what I wanted to do. I thought she was going to do that anyway. And now push it off. Go, Maxie. Show us that you have a brain between the two of your ears. Sweet. Nice one. Although I'm sure the...
MacGyver strikes again.
MacGyver. I'm sure the rope would have snapped, but that's fine. We opened up the trapdoor in the end, so that's all we need to do. All right. Let us go into the basement. And the person that comes back here must be thinking, who the hell is this James Bond character breaking into my house or basement? Breaking into my farm. Ooh.
What is this?
That looks like a bunker. Or a torture room. Either or.
Do I even need to say how weird this is?
He just did. Who built this kind of place?
A Prescott, of course.
Yep. Oh dear. Go with her. There could be someone down there. Well, sirs, I don't like this one bit. Feels like we're about to get abducted. Is that a vault? It is.
This bunker is so surreal.
Ooh. Oh. 5-3-4? 5-3-4? Fuck.
Wrong code.
God damn it, it was 5-3-something. I remember it. I remember it because it was underlined in red and it was the only one when I was investigating that had three numbers. But I can't remember how to look at that again.
This is too heavy to break, so I'll need a code.
Aha! 5-4-2. Oh, come on, Sowers. That was so freaking close. 5-4-2. Ta-da!
Yes! I thought that only worked in the movies.
Sweet, sirs! Now, what is in the vault? What is in the dark room? Holy shit, that is a big door. Feels like we are poking our noses into very dangerous things. Oh, you go, girl. But let us be careful. Holy shit, there's a lot of food here.
Now what the hell is this?
A lot of water.
More survivalist supplies.
But why?
Water supplies. It's like in David's garage bunker.
Yeah, that's right, actually.
Look at these cans. David must shop at the same store.
Interesting. Oh, maybe this is where we're going to find all the files.
Whoa. This says it all about Nathan. He needs help.
As Nathan's primary psychiatrist for over 5 years, I feel that I should stop seeing your son, as you would have disregarded my rather dire and immediate suggestions for his and others' well-being. You know well that the extent of Nathan's challenges, but I feel that you refuse to acknowledge the role you play in his mental health. If I do not have your support, I cannot treat Nathan. It is as simple as that. I fear he is becoming even more disconnected from reality, even if he acts in a personable manner. You have ignored my request for a consultation with you and your wife, so I have to assume that you are no longer interested in my services. Regardless, I care about Nathan, and I believe he needs serious help. If you would like to talk about this matter, I'm always available. See, his father told Nathan that the doctor was away. Just turns out that the doctor was giving his father the things he didn't want to hear. Duct tape.
Duct tape in a bunker is always a bad sign.
You can say that again. Is that a photocopier?
I guess Nathan needs the most expensive printer in the world.
The fuck? For what? Jesus, massive. Ooh, the fuck is this?
That's an original signed illustration. Fits perfect in here.
This is so creepy. Needles and drugs.
Needles? Gross.
Great.
This must be the crap that Nathan gets from Frank.
The fuck is going on here, sirs?
So who's using this fancy tripod?
Hey, look at the camera. See what photos are on there. Maybe there's some of Kate, and maybe there's some of Rachel. That's what we need to know.
I've never seen so much pricey equipment before.
Everything is sketchy as fuck, but nothing about Rachel here.
The apocalypse entertainment system.
At least when the apocalypse does happen, we'll all be entertained. All right, please, let's just find something. Oh, what did I say, sirs? This is all the files.
Come on, let's see what this shit is all about.
Feels like I'm into the world of a mass murderer.
Okay. A binder marked Victoria, but it's empty.
Look, the next one says Kate.
Oh no, Kate. No.
God, I should have killed that bastard back there.
Kate wasn't the first. All those binders are filled with other victims. Victoria has to be next.
Yep.
Nathan must be planning to dose her tonight at the Vortex Club party.
Rachel.
Shit.
This can't be real. These are all post shots, right? Right?
Chloe, look at her face. She's out of it.
Maybe Nathan paid her a shitload of cash to do this. She probably would have.
I don't think so. Why is he putting her in the ground like that? Where?
The junkyard. Max, we have to find that spot now. Then we can see what he did. There's no way she's dead. No
shit.
Way. She posed for those pictures, Max. I know it. Please, let's go.
Take the evidence with you. Go, take the evidence with you.
Oh my God.
Just don't look at the file.
This picture is framed different. Rachel is awake and fucking furious. Rachel has passed out and she has something in her mouth. What happened to her? This shot is so staged. I can't believe it's real. I can't.
Take it with you. This is stuff you can use.
Kate looks so doped up. At least Kate was asleep through all this bullshit.
God damn it. Or at least take a picture. I don't know. Just... Girls.
Whoa.
Okay.
What is going on?
What is this?
Nathan and his
I've
father.
Told you never call me using your phone. Stick with the disposable ones I gave you. I don't want to hear you screaming out my name in public place you have stupidly done before. I haven't set this all up and shared my vast wisdom just so you can fuck it up with your teen rage. We can accomplish a lot together. You're on your own. Oh, his father is definitely onto it. What about the computer? Can we use the computer?
Let's see what's in here.
Not.
Oh my God. No.
The fuck is this? You can't just leave here without taking any evidence.
That son of a bitch.
Howard World Construction and Investment. Sean Preske. Yeah. $1 million. Jesus. But I would take all of this. This is enough to call down the cops. This is crazy. Oh, it's really frustrating that you can't take anything. So she's dead. Oh. But. We'll just have to see. Are you gonna dig with your hands?
Are you gonna help me, Max? Chloe, stop! Look. Please, no. Oh, that smell.
Rachel. No, Rachel, no, no, please, not her.
Fuck.
Who does this?
God damn it. I kind of knew it deep down. And we still have, don't know what this, like, magical dough is. We've taken pictures of it before, but it never appears in our photographs. Oh. Holy sh... Well, I guess we have to deal with Nathan now. Oh, we're actually gonna... This is actually all in this episode. I see two moons. That's a good sign that you're having a good time. Oh, they're here.
I hope Nathan enjoys his last party.
Shit, she has the gun.
We can go right to the cops.
Yeah, exactly.
We have proof. Fuck the police.
No.
Rachel wanted us to find her.
So we get Leo justice. No, killing him is not gonna solve this.
For 100 years, and nobody is gonna get in my way. Especially with your help. Right? I'm with you to the end, Chloe.
That was not the right answer, Max. Oh, come on, no. Yeah, there you go, she's got the gun. Don't do-
Oh, shit. This is like that eclipse.
You're right, look at the outline.
I can't tell if they're different.
What is that?
It can't be two moons.
Jesus, Chloe, look up at the sky.
Holy shit. Beautiful. The guy wasn't high.
Shit. The world is ending. Cool.
You're not listening. Something major is going down.
That's right. Nathan Prescott is going down.
Like, seriously? What the fuck is this?
Welcome to the end of the world, ladies. I'm glad you decided to escort me.
Oh, bro.
You look really good, Warren. Are you alright after
No, dude, what are you doing?
I'm glad you stopped me.
Bro.
Nathan is dangerous.
Chatting up a girl when you're pissed is not a good idea.
Where is he?
I didn't see him at the dorm again. I was held up in my room.
Dude, have you been drinking?
Oh, really?
If you consider half a beer drinking.
Oh, let's Warren, you're so lame.
Hey, hey. I know this is a bad time, but can I get one picture? I've been feeling like this might be actually the end of the world, so I want to have something for prosperity.
Well, I don't blame you, Warren.
Come on, take the goddamn picture.
I know, I'm a pain in the booty. Just one picture.
Action.
Nicely done. Okay, I kind of need
to. Come on,
exactly.
Guys.
Kind of stop my friend committing murder.
I just wanted to feel like a normal student after this week's ultra violence. I never hit anybody like that before. I was always the one getting my ass kicked.
Hey, we still need your expert help. If you see Nathan, text me immediately, okay?
Yeah, I need to save him.
And do not let him see you.
He won't. I know how to be invisible here.
Not to me, bro. Warren. Text soon.
I've gotta go. Man, sober up. There's nothing more of a turnoff than someone who's wasted, in my opinion. Okay, we're at the party.
Can I take your phone or anything?
But no, this is such a bad idea.
I didn't see any tablet with cat pics.
Okay.
Okay, Chloe, where the hell are you?
You're at a party. You don't seem to go to many of these. So can I just go past?
Hey Max, welcome to the end of the world. Do you want me to check anything in?
No.
No thanks, Stella. Have you seen Nathan yet?
No, thank God. That boy creeps me out. Wait, some girl just asked about Nathan before you came in.
Ah, shit. What girl?
What girl?
Is
she had blue hair, dressed like a punk?
God damn it, we've already lost her.
Up those Rachel Amber posters. I'm stuck here, so I'm sorry I can't help you.
So are you working at a Vortex Club party? I didn't think you wanted to be a member.
Screw that. I'm here for the job.
Okay, can we just like get over this? We have more important things to deal with than to catch up and take pictures. Let's bounce. No, wait, do I actually have to go in? Yeah, that makes sense. Okay, let's just enter the club. The club, which is a gym. Sweet. Oh no, it's the pool. Again, alcohol and water is not a good mix. No, at least the DJ is having fun. God, finding anybody in this place is going to be an absolute nightmare. Well, everybody seems to be having fun. No, that's pretty much sums me up on the dance floor. Oh no, Max, you did not. Oh. Look at that face. You better run and you better hide. Run, go before someone notices you. Oh. Fuck. Okay, well that didn't go well. Go back some more. And let's try not and push everything into the water. Oh! But I got past anyway. Excellent. All right, let's go past this carton. And we should be in the VIP club. Oh, we have the choice to warn Emma or not.
Sorry, Max. Vortex Club members only.
Oh, come on.
Sorry. I'm on the guest list.
I'm taking you off.
What?
I don't have time for
I'm here to warn you.
Real cute, Max. And after I apologized to you the other day, do you even have a clue what's going on at Blackwell? Kate Marsh tried to kill herself in front of you and me. Everybody here. That's not my fault, Max. Don't you even try to blame me.
No, I'm not. But let's talk about Nathan.
I blame Nathan for dosing Kate, but nobody at that party even cared she was so wasted.
It's a fucking party. Everybody is wasted. What do you want from me?
Some humanity, Victoria.
I'm the only person here who cares what Nathan is going through.
No, he just wants to drug you and take pictures of you.
This is bigger than a problem, child.
I'm not perfect, okay? I'm a teenager at an art school. I'm only here to become a photographer and get famous.
Yeah, you do have talent, actually.
You have talent, Victoria. You don't have to push people out of your way.
You don't understand. My parents own a gallery. I know how this art game has to be played. It's brutal.
No, it's art. You don't have to play their way. Mr. Jeff,
I can't believe we're talking this in the middle of a club. Do you just know how hard to talk in the middle of a club? It's impossible. Your voice is hoarse over like...
admitting again that I have some talent.
Your voice becomes hoarse in like 2 minutes.
I don't either. Choice you
make. Hard to believe, but I don't always make the best choice.
Yes, and you're gonna make a bad one tonight if you go with Nathan.
We're not supposed to be friends.
Why the hell not? We're both into art and photography. We're both kind of weird and pretentious. If we hung out without attitude, we'd get along fine.
I almost asked you to hang out. You said my photos were Abaddon-esque. Then I remembered who I was.
You should have asked me. It would have been cool to compare photo notes.
Okay, I'm love all about the sisterly bonding here, but get on with it.
Well, Max Caulfield, there's still time for you to get in the Vortex.
We have to warn you.
I actually hope so, Victoria.
Why do you say it like that?
Yes, obviously warn her. Although she might take it badly and say we're inventing. But we need to warn her. Like, whatever happens, I couldn't live with myself if something happened to it with her.
Victoria, listen to me. Your life is in serious danger. I know Nathan is your friend, but he is truly unstable and dangerous. He did drug Kate at that party so he could take her someplace dark.
What? Nice try, Max. But I don't believe you. And why would he do that?
That I don't know yet. But it was enough to make Kate want to die. And I think you're next.
Max, that is crazy. Nathan is like one of my
mass murderers are until they kill you.
He takes serious meds, but that's not his fault. His family treats him like a total freak just because he has little meltdowns. They're not little anymore. They're deadly. I don't care if you hate me or not. You have to believe me.
Come on.
You could have been a major bitch to me when I got hit with that.
Yes.
Pain, and I deserve it.
Think of all the good things I did to you.
I don't hate you. I actually think you're one of the coolest people I've
Boom, respect.
Career, but cool. You just don't know it yet. Maybe I'm jealous because you don't give a shit what anybody thinks. And I do. To be honest, Nathan has been freaking
There you go.
He's not here and I haven't seen him. Just make sure you stay away from him. And stick close to your friends tonight. Okay, I let you boss me around this one time.
You'll thank me later.
I have other people I can go to for protection. Thanks for telling me this, Max.
Okay, sus.
What you said is true. Then you be careful too. I've got my own protection. Text me if you need anything.
I will. Thanks.
For the first time, I'm gonna call her Victoria because we're friends. Okay, sus. Ah, and there's Chloe. I wonder where you'd been. She fits right in this place. Alright, let's go to her then. I'm glad I warned her.
Maybe there's hope yet for Victoria. I'm glad I warned her.
Okay, let's go.
Oh good. Chloe.
Let's leave the party. Oh my god, the frame rate.
Chloe, Nathan isn't here. Nobody has seen him tonight.
Mr. Jefferson? What the hell is he doing here?
Maybe he's hiding in his dorm. Then let's bail. Nathan can't hide anymore.
So, you made it.
What the hell is he doing here?
Are you both okay? You look like you're on.
Well, one of the people here is gonna kill someone.
Looking for Nathan.
I didn't know you were pals with him. I haven't seen him since this afternoon. He seemed pretty upset. I think he's still quite upset over the whole case
Dude,
situation.
Just get out of the way. Just sense. What are you doing?
Let's talk later, Max. I have to announce the winner of the
Go
contest.
For it.
I do wish you would have entered. You have to build up that resume and portfolio.
Oh my god, dude, shut up.
Thanks. I hope so.
Chloe's just like, what the fuck is this guy talking about?
Let's get the hell out of here, Max.
Okay. Okay, though. But we warned Victoria, and that's the important thing.
Okay, everybody calm down. Thank you. I appreciate it. I don't want to get in the way of the party, but it's time to announce the winner of the Everyday Heroes Contest. Before I do, I want to thank everybody who entered their photograph and everybody who thought about entering. This is the most important step in being an artist. Sharing your work with the world.
Come on, we don't
All
care. We didn't even enter.
Blackwell Academy and everything our school stands for. As far as I'm concerned, you're all everyday.
Hey, nice play on words there.
The envelope, please.
Come on.
And the winner is...
Victoria.
Oh my, what a shocker. Victoria
There
Chase.
You go.
Oh my God.
Nicely done.
Thank you so much, Mr. Jefferson. It was your incredible photography that brought me to Blackwell, and I hope I can live up to your name and fame. I also want to thank all the students for being so dedicated in their pursuit. And I'd like to dedicate this prize to Kate Marsh.
Nice.
She is the real everyday hero of Blackwell, and I can't wait for her to
That's
come back.
That's the humanity that we want.
Thank you.
Victoria won. Big surprise. I can't believe she blackmailed Jefferson. Yes, I can. Who fucking cares? Rachel is still dead, and I want Nathan's punk ass now.
Me too. Let's go check out the dormitories.
Okay, sus. Jesus, this episode. I've been recording for 3 hours and 10 minutes. Christ on a bike, that's long.
Nathan just texted me. He says there won't be any evidence left after he's done.
Oh,
shit.
What the fuck did I tell
you?
We
have to go to the junkyard right now.
So aggravating, sirs. It's so aggravating in these story type games when it, to me, actually, it breaks a little bit the immersion. And I don't know, maybe a lot of people think like me, and obviously it's impossible to have all the options, but I just wish we had more. The ability to take the file from the desk, for example. Take photos while you're in there. I don't know, small things like that. Oh. Chloe, you better not shoot him. But this place is super creepy at night. Okay, can we... Yeah, let's go. You know where the body is, right? So let's get a move on.
You're gonna suffer, Nathan.
Anyway, with that text... That text is very incriminating in the first place. Okay. Where is it? Chloe, you're guiding me here, I hope. Oh, fucking owl.
If I catch Nathan, you better rewind so I can kill him. Over.
You won't get the satisfaction, though.
For God's sake, Chloe, you have to be quiet. We could die, okay?
Is it here? Where is the body? God damn it, why is it so creepy? Nathan!
Rachel!
Come out!
Max, please hurry!
I'm right here behind you.
Oh God, Max, look. She's still there.
Okay.
Don't look, Chloe.
Where's Nathan, though? Oh, fuck. Rewind, rewind. Oh, come on, she couldn't rewind. Shit.
Chloe, look out.
What the fuck?
Well, shit. Holy crap. Oh, it's right through the head as well. Well then. Oh, I bet it's gonna be his dad or something. Oh. Oh. What a twist. What a twist. Holy crap. Holy crap. Okay, before I go into the stats, I just want to say that I knew there was something dodgy about Mr. Jefferson. I called that crap like 2 episodes ago. Oh, but I didn't want to be right, and I was. Oh, so it's not Nathan. But then that doesn't make sense, the connection to the Prescott family. How is that interlinked? Oh, but that was cool, though. Interesting, sirs. Oh, that was a good twist. That was a very, very satisfying episode. The problem was it was way, way too freaking long. Okay, so let's look at the stats. 42% refused Chloe. So interesting, I was in the minority there. I was in the majority for stopping Warren. I was in... Yeah, that makes sense. And I was in the majority to make Victoria believe in your warning. Okay, let's see what the preview for the next episode is like. Mr. Jefferson, I trusted you, you bastard. Ooh, and that will be the last one. Holy shit, sirs. This has been a really good episode. I have no idea how I'm gonna split it. I think I'm going to have to edit this one a lot more, sirs. I hope you sirs don't mind. If not, I'll be, like I said, just uploading 3 hours of footage. And considering it took me 36 hours to upload an hour and 20 minutes, I think I'll be here for days. So I'm not going to do that. I'll try and make the episodes as shortest as possible. So aim for an hour like they always are. And yeah, I really hope you sirs liked this episode of Life is Strange. A shit ton happened, and I'm just loving this series. So if you did like this episode and you are enjoying the series, please don't forget to bestow a like and subscribe to become a sir today. So as always, stay cool, stay classy, and I will see you sirs in the next episode. Oh, that's the one you... But you taught me that word. Well, sirs, this is a pretty depressing start to the episode, to say the least. Mr. Jefferson. See, a teacher that handsome would never be in a backwater town like this, except if he wanted to hide.